Stay tuned for another grocery haul featuring sell items and Ibotta. Hi everyone, Marlene, aka SnowGardener307, here with you today for a quick grocery haul video. I do want to let you guys know I took no time to prep before I went out of town today to take my son to the orthodontist, but it was grocery shopping day, so I did have some meal plans made and I got what I could. So let me get you turned around. This is my grocery haul, and I'm pretty excited with how I did. And so from Smith's, line is right there for produce. And then I picked up a few things from Walmart, which we will talk about. But let's go ahead and start with Smith's. I was cell shopping, trying to stock the pantry again. And it is right now, like almost midnight, like 20 to midnight on July 1st. And let's see what we've got. So Suddenly Salad were on sale. I only buy Suddenly Salad when they are on sale because here in my local town, Suddenly Salad is $3.19 a box and there is no way that I'm gonna do that. So they were on sale for 99 cents. So I grabbed 10 of them. I grabbed one, two, I thought I grabbed more than two classics. I think I must've messed up when I put these together. There's some more classics. So four classics. Two Caesars, and then I got three BLT, I think, and two Bacon Ranch. I love having these during the summer because they are a great side dish to go ahead and add to a barbecue. I made myself a little cheat sheet because the Ibotta deals, I just have to share them with you guys as I'm going through. So we were out of chips, crackers, things like that, so I did stockpile a little bit here. For the Ritz, I grabbed three boxes of the crisp and thins. I've got the cream cheese and onion, the salt and vinegar, and the cheddar. And then I grabbed two boxes of the cheese crispers cheddar. These were an Ibotta deal, and they were also on sale. So they were on sale for $1.88 at Smith's for each one, and you could have, for the Ibotta, up to five. So $1.88, $1.25 Ibotta, so 63 cents a piece. Super excited about those. Another Ibotta deal was the English muffins by Thomas, and they were at my Smith's for $2.99. There was Ibotta deal for $2.48 off, so these cost me 57 cents. And then let's see, we've got some other Ibotta deals, but they're a little bit further down. So we've got some other items that were on sale. I'm going to try to remember the prices, but I can't promise you. Doritos were on sale for $1.77 if you grabbed three. So I did a spicy sweet chili, a spicy nacho, and a regular nacho. Lay's potato chips were also on sale for the same thing. So I grabbed a sweet Southern Heat barbecue. Never had that before. A wavy Lay, and a cheddar and sour cream. Right now, our Smith's, and I'm sure most Kroger stores around the United States, had the buy five, save five. So the goldfish were on that. So these ended up being 99 cents. So I grabbed a pizza one, a Frank's Red Hot, which I've never seen before, and there was only one, or else I probably would have bought more. And I grabbed two Flavor Blasted Cheddar, which are back there. And then the Rice Krispie Treats were on the same deal for that. I don't remember their price, so I'll go ahead and put it right up here for you. I grabbed the M&M ones and the originals. Then we're going to be doing some tacos. So I grabbed some little street taco tortillas. These were on sale. Again, don't remember what, so let me put the price here. Then, super excited, the Olay Extreme Wellness tortillas were on sale for $1.99, so I grabbed five of them for myself, and these are good till August 10th, so those are going to last me. I love these chicken creations. This is the chicken salad, and I love taking these for my lunch because they're only 70 calories. So they're a great thing to possibly wrap up in a tortilla or put on a salad. And these were on sale for $1.99. Then let's get into the mini wheats. This is another Ibotta deal. And when I wasn't sure if the cinnamon roll was going to be on the Ibotta, but when I scanned it, it worked. So I grabbed three regular frosted mini wheats and two cinnamon roll because that's the only kind that Smith's had. And they were on sale at Smith's for $1.49. And there was an Ibotta deal where you could get up to 5 for 60 cents off. So I got these boxes of cereal, you guys, for 89 cents. So super good score there. Then I grabbed myself some more snacks for my lunch. And these were part of the buy 5, save 5 as well. I grabbed the Fiber One strawberry cheesecake bars. I haven't had these in years. They sounded delicious. And then I grabbed myself the blueberry pastry crisps and also the brown sugar pastry crisps. And these are the 100 calorie snacks. Again, don't remember their price, so I will let you guys know that. Then when I had went grocery shopping, I was starving. Absolutely starving. I realized at, it was like 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I hadn't eaten all day. I don't know how that happened. Super busy. So I grabbed these little chocolate mini cookies and I think I ate 3 while I was grocery shopping and they were $1.59. That the bakery was the first thing I headed to and I just wanted to find something inexpensive and they were pretty good. And then I grabbed this Penang curry cooking sauce kit from Blue Dragon. It was a clearance item. And I will let you guys know what it is, but I've never had it before. And it just sounded delicious because I love Penang curry. And so it looks like all I need to add is the meat. Because it's got coconut milk, it's got herbs and spices. So I need to look into it a little bit more. I do know it was less than $2, but again, I'll put the sale price on here. I have to pick up a chicken packet that I dropped on my foot. So give me 1 second. Okay, packet dropped on my foot. Then we needed some milk. I just grabbed 1 gallon because I only took one cooler. This was $2.99. Then another thing for the buy 5, save 5 was the silk. It was on sale for $1.99 when you took that off. So I went ahead and grabbed 5. I love to use these in my quick oats and also just a drink when I'm watching my calories. So I went ahead and grabbed 2 unsweet almond, a chocolate, and it's a dark chocolate, unsweet vanilla, and an unsweet almond and coconut. I've never had this one before, so I figured what better time to try it. But I like using this when I eat cereal because it's only 30 calories. So right now I am calorie counting and I love chocolate milk and this is pretty dang good, especially for 100 calories. Then another Ibotta deal. Never tried these before. These are the reduced fat crescents. They're 90 calories, so perfect for me counting calories. And they were an Ibotta deal where when you got them, they ended up being free. So gotta love that. We needed some sliced cheese. So Kroger had their brand of cheese on 4 for $6. So I grabbed 4. I got an extra sharp, a medium cheddar, a Gouda, and aged sharp white cheddar. These were the 4 kinds that were left. The store was pretty empty of those, but that was okay. I went ahead and grabbed some Kraft singles. They were part of that buy 5, save 5. So these were $1.99. And then I grabbed some burritos just to throw in the freezer with teenagers and my husband. And even I like these stupid little bean and cheese burritos. They were 5 for $2. And then let me tell you guys about this deal right here. We'll come back to the Chobani's. So Philadelphia cream cheese. It was part of the buy 5, save 5. So they were 99 cents a piece. And then there was an Ibotta deal for 50 cents off. So I got Philadelphia name brand cream cheese for 49 cents. Can't beat that deal. Super excited. Chobani flips. Believe it or not, from the last time I went grocery shopping, we have 1 left. So they were on sale, 10 for 10. So I bought 10. I got a couple of the cookie doughs. Those were super yummy. The salted caramel crunch is always a favorite. The chocolate haze craze, super yummy. Cookies and cream. The Rocky Road, which I didn't get to try. I think my son ate it, so I still want to try that one. The strawberry cheesecake I enjoyed. Always loved the peach cobbler. And mint chocolate chip is a favorite in my house, so we got that. All right, now let's get to the produce. And you're going to see that I got some reduced sticker produce here. Now, let's see. I went ahead and grabbed 2 chopped salad kits. These are for my lunch. I grabbed the avocado ranch. I've never actually had this one. They don't carry this one at my store. And so servings per container, 3. So it looks like 130 calories per serving. And they're saying there's 3 in here, so you could eat the whole bag for $3.90, which isn't bad. A lot of times I'll divide this into 2 meals. And then I got the sunflower crunch, which is my absolute favorite.
And it's higher in calories, of course, 170 calories. And like I said, I normally eat half the bag. Then I went ahead and grabbed just a little bit over a pound of cherries for myself. Love taking cherries to work to eat on and munch on for a low calorie snack. For our tacos that we're going to be making this week, we are going to be using one of the street taco kits that I got on the last grocery haul. And for toppings, it recommended shredded carrots and green onions. So I grabbed some shredded carrots and some green onions. Of course, I don't remember the prices on those. And then when I make tacos, when I do the street tacos, I like making regular tacos too. Great leftovers to have two different kinds of tacos. So we have got some tomatoes and some avocados for that. Avocados were on sale for $1.25. I needed some lettuce. And look at this little bag right here. It looks amazing still, you guys. 49 cents. And it is the shredded green leaf lettuce. And it is dated the 3rd. And today is the 1st. So it's still got a couple days. And it looked better, honestly, than the lettuce that wasn't marked down. Then I have never tried this brand of the chopped salad kit, but those chopped salad kits were $3.99. This one was 89 cents. It's a homestyle ranch. And when I looked at it, it looked really good. So I'll actually be taking this tomorrow night to work. And it looks like for the whole package, it says there's 380 calories. So I'll eat that one first. And then they had this bag of nectarines for 99 cents. And let me open it up so you guys can see. They still look amazing. Like this one, super yummy. You know, there's like, I think one in here that's super soft. Like this one right here, this side of it's pretty dang soft, but this side's still good. So I think I might take these and go ahead and chop those up and take those to or for my lunch. So this is my grocery haul and I've got my little cheat sheet right here. So let me move that off to the side. And I want to tell you guys, I impressed myself with this one. That's a lot of groceries, right, you guys? We got a good variety. We are stockpiling the pantry. Okay, so apparently my camera cut out. I did watch where I ended. So let me tell you guys, as I had said just a second ago, but it didn't record, I impressed myself with this grocery haul. And when the total rang up, I was so excited. So this right here before the Ibotta deals rang up for $1.41. Sorry about that, guys. It is almost midnight. Like I said, look at that, 11:56. It rang up for $142. Now, let me tell you guys about my Ibotta. My Ibotta was $15.26. So that dropped this down to $126.74. And I do want to let you guys know that I didn't catch it, but it was should have actually been cheaper than that because these cereals right here, the two cinnamon rolls, even though they were marked for the $1.49 sale, they were $3.99. So they were $2.50 more. So that was $5 more than I thought for cereal. And we'll get over it, right? It's not the end of the world. But if those would have rang in correct, that would have been $121. So that would have been even cooler. But that is where we are sitting for our groceries. And we had $150 because we had lowered our grocery budget. So we did amazing. Now, next, let me tell you guys what I bought at Walmart. I don't know prices. I don't think I know prices, just so you guys know. We went in for a few things. We went in for oil for my husband, plus an oil filter. I wanted a bottle of lotion. That was all we were supposed to get. And then my son ended up buying himself a Nintendo Switch. And he was super excited about that. He bought it, right? He works his butt off and he bought it. He bought himself some games. So he spent quite a bit of money. And we saw these little bites and they're already opened up because I grabbed my daughter after I had went shopping. So these, I believe, were $4.99. And oh my gosh, you guys, I love peanut butter M&Ms. This was my splurge. And I know they were five something, but I can't remember exactly how much. And then, like I said, I went in to get a big bottle of lotion. I just grabbed the Equate brand. I find it works quite well. And since I was at Walmart, the mosquitoes are horrendous. So I grabbed some more mosquito spray. And then I realized when we were at Walmart that Smith's didn't really have any drinks that were in really good sale. So we went ahead and picked a few of these up. My son takes one of these to work with him almost every day because he works his hiney off and sweats. And so he'll drink it and then he'll fill it with water. So the Powerades, I believe, were 79 cents at Walmart. And then I saw this generic brand of these. So these Clear Americans, and they were 50 some cents. So we grabbed six of those, and it looks like 10 of the Powerade. And my son gets the zero sugar. Not that I think he just doesn't like drinking the extra calories. He doesn't necessarily have to worry about that, but I am kind of glad that he's not just mindlessly drinking calories. So I don't know exactly how much this stuff from Walmart costs because I'm going to have to subtract the oil and stuff out. And as I said, it is almost the next day, so I'm a little bit tired. But when I edit this, I will go ahead and put the Walmart total right here. Still a great deal at Walmart. And so I will add this stuff into the groceries and we'll see. I'm pretty sure we came in under that 150, but this is also part of the stockpile money and the out of town money that I received, because I never would have spent $10 on Silk almond milk if I didn't have stockpile money. So that is what we've got. So thank you guys for joining me. I hope you found this food haul interesting, if nothing else. I want to thank my friend Crystal from What Was Mommy Thinking to encourage me to search out those Ibotta deals. And I didn't even look at the Ibotta deals until I was in the store, quite honestly, just because I didn't have time. And so for meal plan, we are doing a frozen lasagna and garlic breadsticks that are in the freezer already on Monday. And I'm by myself this weekend, so those salads and stuff you see are going to be for the weekend. Then on Tuesday, we're doing those tacos that I was talking about. And on Wednesday, we are going to do some what we call Dagwood sandwiches, because we've got a lot of lunch meat that we need to be eating through before it goes bad. And we'll use some of the tomato and lettuce that I bought for the tacos for those as well. And then we are going to do leftovers on Thursday. And then Friday is actually a new week. We're going to see what else we can pull together, but that's what I've done so far. All right, everybody. I hope you all have a blessed day, and I will talk to you soon. Remember, keep on smiling. Bye, everybody. Hi, everybody. I know I said goodbye last night for the tour, but I've been having a lot of people ask about my pantry, my fridge, and my freezers. So I'm going to show you guys what they look like. I just got done putting all of the groceries away. I do want you guys to know that I did not clean whatsoever. So the first place we're going to go to is the garage freezer. It is probably a mess. Keeping it real on my channel, haven't had a chance to organize it in a while, and it is packed full. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. Okay, everyone, our garage is a big mess right now, along with the freezer. So let's start with the door right here. So we've got all of our sausages, hot dogs, meatballs up here. And this is just some pork fat that we will use for other things. I've got easy meals, things like that, and some rolls here. And then riced cauliflower for me, a couple loaves of bread, and some bagel thins for me as well. And then we flip around, and this is an older freezer, and boy, do I need to pull everything out and get it clean. So on the top up here, this is all pork. This is all going to be sausage, pork chops, things like that. And then we get into kind of a disaster area shelf. If you guys remember on my food haul, I had bought these naan breads, so I've got those there. I buy tortillas at my store when they're on sale for 99 cents, so I've got those. I've still got these great big huge bags of pepperoni that I got for 99 cents, and I need to pull one of those out, start eating those out. Then we've got some potatoes. We've got some hash browns. I'm going to be using one of those for breakfast burritos for dinner one night this week. We've got some tater tots. Those are one of our favorites, or actually, I guess they're the rounds. I've got a big bag of broccoli florets. And then we've got some fish fillets back there. We'll be eating that for one of our meals this week as well. And that right there is the top to our wedding cake, which will be going bye-bye here soon, thank goodness. And these are the sausages that I had found on clearance. And since I have you guys out here, I feel like I need to go ahead and fix stuff. I've also got a pack of ground turkey. I think I'm going to, sorry, I know you guys aren't seeing anything in the video. I think I'm going to go ahead and make some lettuce wraps with that ground turkey. I normally use ground chicken. And then we've got some chicken right there. So that's what these turkey sausages were covering. There we go. Look at that. It's amazing when it just takes a second to get things back into looking a little bit better. Then down here, we have got more pork on this side, and this is from the half a pig we bought. Then we have got beef. We've got a great big huge beef roast there and all of the ground beef. And then we've got some meals that I have made. So I think we've got stew in there. We've got chili in there. We've got spaghetti sauce, taco soup. Then down here on the bottom of the very dirty freezer, and these two things are going to be used this week, and then I'm going to wipe this out, and this is what we have left from our deer last year. All right, everybody, so that is a look at the freezer out here. Let me go ahead and show you guys the pantry. For those of you guys that have never seen my pantry, this is the pantry that we built, and it is in our laundry room. And so this is my husband's area there, so don't mind that, but we've got washer and dryer in here. This is all non-food stuff, so I've got extra stuff up here. So this is my stockpile that I like to keep. And I also have a white cupboard on the other side of the room that has extra soap, stuff like that as well, because I am a true stockpiler. Okay, up on top, we have got all baking spices, seasoning things, all of that good stuff. We've got one thing of coffee back there. We've got some salsas. There's our cereal stack with our mini wheats added to it. The oldest cereal is on this stack here, so that's how we pull from it. And then I've kind of got my breakfast area, and I just put all of my snacks in here. It still says Weight Watcher snacks, which is fine. I'm not on Weight Watchers right now, but I am watching my calories. And then our canned goods are going down, so I'm starting to put jarred stuff in front, but I've got canned salsa back there and some canned asparagus. I need to make some tuna and make a big tuna salad and put a jar of that pickled asparagus in there. It's absolutely delicious. Then we have got pasta, sides, hamburger helper, things like that. Great big old huge stack of mac and cheese. I don't use hamburger helper a lot, so luckily we've only got a few of those left, but we've got some potatoes in there. We've got all of the new Suddenly salads that I just purchased. And then we've got pastaroni and rice-a-roni kind of back in this corner. My pantry is ever evolving, just like my budget, because depending on what's on sale, depends on what I need room for. This basket right here is what we deem our pasta basket, and sometimes we have other things in there. Right now I've got some Chinese noodles in there, and I've got some pink Himalayan sea salt just because it stocks in there easier. Then we've got our baking basket, and boy is it full. So we've got all kinds of sugar substitutes, coconut, chocolate chips, all of that type of stuff in there. Then we get down into the snacks. I use this right here, as you can see, for Kool-Aid, for Jell-O. We don't use Kool-Aid a ton, but when I have nieces and nephews and stuff come over, then we use that. We've got some croutons. We've got some crackers. You can see the new Ritz Crispers. This is my snack basket right here. So the muffins that were on the haul are right back here. These are from the last haul. I try to put the little bags of chips in here so they'll get eaten up. I think we've got four left. There are those Rice Krispie treats from the haul. Here are all the goldfish. We still have some Chex Mix and such from the last haul. More Ritz Crispers. And then all of this is the chips that we just got. So this shelf was pretty empty before the grocery haul. Down here, we've got some canned goods. Not super full because nothing's been on sale. So we've got any of our tomato-based products I like to put over here, so we've only got a few. We have got the taco kit that we're going to be using this week, and then that's the curry that I just made right there. And we've got some more canned goods right in here, and then we've got condiments in here. And then, like I said, on this side, we've got things such as Ziploc bags, sponges, sprays, you know, Kleenexes, soaps, things like that. So let me go ahead and turn you guys around here. And this is one of our inner freezers. So this is where I put all of the meals that I got the last time. So I did have room for those in here, thank goodness. And you can see I've got some more beef in here that I actually need to take out to the outside freezers. These are from a few weeks ago that just never got put out there. So we've got all of our frozen meals there. We still have more deer in here. We've got some ribs. Here are those burgers that I got on sale for $1.50. We made those up, just so you guys know. Absolutely delicious. And then we've got Cool Whip up here. We've got those street tacos that I purchased before. This is my homemade cream of mushroom soup. I probably should make a batch of stroganoff. I'll probably do that this next week. We've got some waffles. And then there are those smart grounds that I went ahead and bought because I thought they looked interesting and they were on sale. And then I have pulled this roast and put it right here because that is going to be made into French dips. Then the English muffins that I just bought, we don't need any of those right now. More cream of mushrooms, and then we've got green chilies. I need to roast some green chilies this year and freeze them. And homemade jelly we're just about out of as well, so we're going to have to get working on that. Now let's look in this fridge. It's a mess. Don't look too closely. So up at the top, we have got all the tortillas that I just bought. There are the bagel thins that I'm eating right now. I have got some Premier Protein shakes, singles, stuff like that. This is why we're having Dagwood sandwiches. We have a turkey and a ham that need to get eaten up, so that's on our grocery list for this week. There are all the chobanis, and I have eggs and sugar-free fruit in there from before. There is all the silk almond milk that I purchased, along with the Powerades. You can see I do have a few sodas, but not too many, and we keep beer in our bottom coolers, or bottom crispers, because we don't need vegetables here. These are gardening seeds, just so you guys know. Then I've got butter, sugar-free puddings for me. There are the cream cheeses we just bought, so I only had one cream cheese, so that was perfect. More soda and drinks there. All right, so that is that. Now let's go here into the kitchen and let's take a look. I don't know what it looks like, you guys. Oh, it's not too bad. So, fridge. This is the fridge we live out of, obviously. It is not super full. I know the top shelf looks full, but that's because that milk's almost gone and I've got a cashew milk and I put an almond milk in there. Open bottle of wine. This is typical in my house, just so you guys know. Open bottle of wine for when I want a glass of wine. We have got my English muffins, and this is why I froze the other ones. We still have three. We've got some tortillas. We've got some hot dogs that we were eating on there. And then in our drawer, this is our cheese, tortilla, meat drawer, so heaven knows what's in here. All the cheeses, any sort of meats, stuff like that. We've got, what is that, bacon? Ah, yeah. This is from Sam's Club. This is so yummy, you guys. These bacon crumbles, absolutely delicious. We've got pepperoni in there. I have all my Laughing Cow cheese wedges in there. And then here I've got some sugar-free applesauces and some sugar-free puddings in there. I've got my sugar-free fruit in there. And I shouldn't say sugar-free for this. It's no sugar added, just so you guys know. More eggs. And then I put these nectarines right here so they wouldn't get forgotten. There's my cherries from last night. There is the produce that I just bought. I had a few tomatoes left over. Besides that, the produce drawer was empty. And the bottom drawer is empty. And then, of course, we've got our condiments in here. And boy, do we like our condiments. We love pickles. We love different types of mustards, jellies, all of that type of stuff. All right. Now let's look at this freezer here. Top shelf. This is all frozen meals. This is mainly my son's meals. He did really enjoy these ones that I bought before, but he still loves his Salisbury steaks, things like that. So that is what's on that shelf. And then this shelf, and I don't know why, but ever since my husband bought this freezer, it falls like that. This is all breakfast stuff. So we've got bacon in there. We've got a couple sausages. There is breakfast burritos. And then to make our lives easier, I put the new burritos in the back so they're not breakfast. Toaster strudels. Then we've got a hodgepodge of whatever I don't have room for. There's usually meat on this right here and some things that I made for myself. And then down here we kind of have a hodgepodge as well. We've got some burgers in there, some rolls. Anything that's opened in the freezer goes down here. Now you guys know what I talk about when I say I have a food hoarding problem. So, but I love it. I really do, as long as I have room for it, as long as we have the money for it. Because if something happens, like COVID happened, I didn't worry during COVID, right? I have toilet paper, I have food, I have all of that. The only thing that does worry me, because we have freezers full, is when the electricity goes out. So I don't know if you guys noticed, but in the big freezer out there, I do have frozen gallons of water. And those are in the freezer for that purpose, just in case, you know, the power goes out or anything. We can leave it in there and it will help keep it colder. All right, everybody. So this is really goodbye. I am actually headed outside to work in the garden. So I hope you guys all have a blessed day. And like I said, last night at midnight, or actually it was this morning, you guys just keep smiling. All right. Bye, everybody.